Good morning, scholars. Today in 10th physics, I have taken the chapter electricity. Over here, the first topic undertaken is your electric current. First, the definition of what is an electric current. Electric current, we know it's a very common thing, but we need to know the formal definition of the electric current. Electric current, it is the rate of flow of charges, as I have written, you can see it. So basically, you need to understand which type of charges are over here. Here the charges are basically the negative charges, that is your electrons. Now the rate, the physics meaning of rate is time, as I have told you in the earlier classes also. So it is the rate of flow of charges, and whenever it is the rate always comes, that is the time always comes as a denominator. So over here we can formulate this thing that electric current is equal to charge upon time. Now, if you see the symbols, if we transfer this into symbolic representation, then the symbol of electric current is I, the symbol of charge is Q, and the symbol of time is T. So, the formula becomes I is equal to Q upon T. Next, what are the units? Units are of two types. This also I have said in the earlier classes. One, the unit which we can derive from the formula. And in examination or the test, if you write the formula unit instead of SI unit, if by any confusion, then there will not be any deduction of the mass. So you need to understand the formula derived unit also. Now the formula unit, it is basically in the numerator, it is the charge, and the SI unit of your charge is your coulomb. So we can have coulomb, and the unit of time is second. So it is the second. So we can write coulomb upon second, that is C upon S. And the SI unit is always the standard of international system. They always honor the scientist whose has an enormous contribution into the topic. So over this particular topic, I have written in the science corner, you can see that is your Marie Andre Ampere. So to honor him, the SI unit of electric current is your ampere. Then in the key points, I have written this charge, which is electron, which I have already described. Now the next is the path or the flow through which electric current need to go through, so that the third and the final phase of physics, that is the applied physics or the engineering physics, we can get it. That is the ultimate purpose, that is to the human society. Like all the devices and the privileges we are getting nowadays, that for that a road has to be there to flow for the electric current. And the name of that path is called electric circuit. Over here you can see the schematic diagram of the electric circuit. This is just the basic diagram. Over here you can see there is a cell. This, a pair of positive and the negative terminal. This is called cell. And when this single pair, this extends to more than one, that is more than a pair of terminal, more than one positive terminal, more than one negative terminal, then that cell is named as battery. Then next is the conductor, which is the purpose to get operational or the functional. Then over here you can see A, which stands for the ammeter. Ammeter, basically it is a device to measure the magnitude of the electric current, that is how much electric current is flowing, how much ampere is flowing. This device ampere also you will be finding in the lab when we will be seeing, when we will be doing the actual devices and we will be doing the practical lab activities. Then there is a key in the commonsman language. It is your basically a switch. So when the dot is inside, that means this key is on, the switch is on, and the electric circuit is operational, current is flowing. When there is no dot inside it, that means this is off and no electric current is flowing through this. So this is the basic of electric current and electric circuit. Thank you.